imposter syndrome is an irrational feeling of insecurity or self-doubt despite no evidence supporting such a belief. It is an internal experience of believing that you're not as competent as others perceive you to be. Have you heard about imposter syndrome? Let me know in the comment section down below. If you have, also let me know in the comment section down below what you know about imposter syndrome. If you stick through to the end of this video, we're going to be looking at the definition, the various causes, the types, and the possible ways to cope with imposter syndrome, all in this video. Hello, welcome to Moments with Ogo. In this channel, we discuss everything health, beauty, and lifestyle. If you're new to this channel, please do well to hit the subscribe button. Also, put on your notification button to get notification whenever we post new video. To my returning subscribers, thank you so much for finding value in my content. I look forward to an amazing ride with every one of us. Please also remember to comment, like, and share our videos. Also, give us ideas on what you want to see on the channel next. Thank you so much. So let's go straight into our topic for today. Imposter syndrome makes you feel you'll be exposed as a fraud any minute. And this usually stems from perfectionism. Also, certain social contents which you're going to see as we explore the video. Imposter syndrome can affect anybody, no matter your social status, your type of work, your skill level, or even your degree of expertise. Imposter syndrome is characterized by a feeling of self-doubt, a tendency to overachieving due to the perceived self-doubt. These individuals also attribute their success to external factors because it just feels too good to be from them. They also set these lofty goals and feel down when they don't achieve it. They are unable to realistically assess their competence and skills. And there is always this looming fear of not meeting up to expectations. These negative feelings also cause them to berate their performance. There's also a heightened tendency to procrastination, and this is just because the feelings drive them to develop high standards. And instead of not meeting those expectations, they rather leave those projects undone. And while this can fuel their motivation to achieve, it usually comes at the cost of having constant anxiety. Overachieving sets up a vicious circle where they think that the only reason they got a job perhaps is because they overprepared, and this creates a reinforcing belief in their mind. The problem, however, is that doing well at something does not really change these beliefs. It's like the more they achieve, the more it's difficult for them to internalize this success. These core beliefs are so strong that they do not change, and while they achieve success, they can't own up to those success, and this drives them to keep achieving and creates a vicious circle where they are always trying to prove that they are not fraudsters, driving them towards overachieving most of the time. Eventually, these feelings usually drives them towards depression due to unmet expectations. They may also experience social anxiety due to unmet expectations. Currently, imposter syndrome is not recognized by the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorder. However, it is estimated that about 70% of people experience at least one episode of imposter syndrome in their lifetime, and that is such a high percentage. If you think you experience imposter syndrome, you can ask yourself these basic questions. Do you agonize over even the smallest mistake or flaws in your work? Do you attribute your success to external factors? Are you sensitive even to constructive criticism? Do you think you will eventually be found as a fraud? Or do you downplay your expertise even when you have genuine skills? If you answered yes to any of those questions, then it's possible you do experience imposter syndrome. But not to worry, everybody experiences it once in a while. Some of the causes of imposter syndrome include coming from a family where there is high value achievement. In such a setting, there's going to be a very high pressure on the individual to perform. And even when they meet those expectations, they can't own up to the achievement. The achievement feels alien to them. What they've achieved feels so surreal that they don't think they actually achieve those things despite having put in every effort to make it a reality. Other causes also include having parents who switch rapidly from being praiseful to criticism, as well as starting a new job or business. There are various types of imposter syndrome. The first types are the perfectionists. These ones are never satisfied with their work. They feel it could have been better. Rather than focus on the strength, they focus on the flaws, and this would eventually cause them anxiety. The superheroes. They feel a type of inadequacy, and this compels them to push themselves to work as hard as possible just to fill up for those inadequacies. The experts. They always learn more and more, but are never satisfied with their level of understanding. Even though they are quite skilled, they always underrate themselves. The natural genius. They always set lofty goals and feel crushed when they don't meet the goals. The soloist. They prefer to work alone, and self-worth usually comes from self-productivity. They reject any form of assistance. In fact, they see asking for help as a sign of weakness. To deal with imposter syndrome, first ask yourself these basic questions. What are the core beliefs you hold about yourself? Do you believe you're worthy of being loved the way you are? And most importantly, must you be perfect before others should approve of you? One of the ways of dealing with imposter syndrome is sharing your feelings. These irrational thoughts tend to grow when they are hidden, but then when you discuss about them, you see it from the lens of other people's view, and you will come to see these thoughts as just irrational thoughts, which are just defective patterns of thinking that really have no weight. Focusing on others also helps in dealing with imposter syndrome, and this is because it takes the attention away from you to other people, therefore distracting your mind from ruminating on those irrational thoughts. Trying to assess your abilities and the effort put in to achieve certain skills also help to boost your confidence and discredit these irrational thoughts that make you feel irrelevant in the midst of your achievements. Take baby steps. Instead of focusing on doing things perfectly, rather take steps to accomplish and celebrate yourself for actually taking those steps. Questioning your thoughts can also make you come to the terms that they are actually irrational and hold no weight. Stop comparison. This only reinforces the imposter syndrome and robs you of happiness. Use social media wisely. There is a tendency to compare your reality with social media fiction. Always remember that people would only post what they want you to see and not necessarily the reality of their lives. Move despite those feelings. Everybody experiences this once in a while, but never let it stop your goals. Just keep moving. Remember, nobody expects you to be an expert. Just keep showing up. You're not alone. There are actually prominent figures who have been reported to have experienced imposter syndrome. We'll start with Maya Angelou. She said, and I quote, "I have written 11 books, but each time I think, oh, they are going to catch me now. I have run a game on everybody, and they are going to find me out now." Also, Michelle Obama. On a visit to see the Queen of England at the Windsor Castle, she was so preoccupied about following the royal protocol that she felt she was not deserving when the Queen asked her to enter, abandoning the protocol. As well as the great physicist Albert Einstein. So if you're experiencing imposter syndrome, you probably have achieved some degree of success in your life that you're attributing to luck. Instead, you can turn those feelings into feelings of gratitude and seek a mental health expert when it becomes unhealthy. And remember, your greatest competitive advantage is that there is only one you, so go crush it. If you got value in this video, please subscribe, comment, like, and share our videos. Until next time, see you.